Watch how the moon sits in the sky on a dark night, shining with the light from the sun. The sun doesn't give the light to the moon, assuming the moon's gonna go with one.
Let's meet contestant number one. He's a schizophrenic serial killer clown who says women love his sexy smile. Let's find out if his charm will work on Sharon. Sharon, what's your question?
Contestant number one, I believe first impressions last forever. So let's say you were to come over to my parents' house and have dinner with me and my family. Tell me what you do to make that first impression really stick.
Let's see. Well, I'd have to think about it. I might show up in a tux, but I doubt it. I'd probably just show up naked like I always do. And look your mama in the eye and tell her, fuck you! Hurry up, bitch, I'm hungry. I smell spaghetti. I'd pinch her loopy ass and tell her, get my food ready. Your dad would probably start tripping and get me pissed. I'd have to walk up and bust him in his fucking lips. It's dinner time. We're hearing grace from your mother. I'd pull the 40 out and force him for your little brother. I'm steady staring at your sister. I'll tell you this. You know, for only 13, she got some big tits. After that, try to jump again, and only this time I'd put the 40 to his chin. After your mom does the dishes and the silverware, I'd try fuck her till I nut in my underwear.
Now let's meet contestant number two. He's a psychopathic, deranged, crackhead freak who works for the Dark Carnival. He says women call him stretch nuts. Sharon, let's hear your question.
I like a man who's not afraid to show his true emotions. A man who expresses himself in his own special way. Number two, if you fell in love with me, exactly how would you let me know?
First thing, I could never love you. You sound like a witchy bitch, yo, fuck you. But if I did, I'd probably show you that I care by taking all these other motherfuckers out of here. I'd go through your phone book and whack them all. If I could test it, number one, I'd break his fucking jaw. Anyone who looked at you would have to pay. I'd be blowing fucking nuggets off all day. I'd grab your titties and stretch them down past your waist. Let them go and watch them both spring up in your face. I sing love songs to you the best I can. Get you naked and hit it like a caveman. Then we go to the beach and walk through the sand. I throw a little in your face and say I'm just playing. As you spit it all out, I rub your back and grab your underwear and wet it up your ass crack.
Well, it sounds like contestant number two is just overflowing with sensitivity, Sharon. It's a tough choice so far. Sharon, let's have your last question and see which one is going to win the rights to your Ned.
Okay, if we were at a dance club and you both noticed me at the same time, tell me, how would you each get my attention and what would your pickup line be? Whoever can see this win.
Okay, first I slide up to the bar and tell you that I can't believe how fucking fat you are. I tell you that I like the way you make your titty shake. And if you lost a little weight, you'd look like Ricky Lake. Fuck that! You'd be talking me quick. I'd order you a drink and stir it with my dick. And then to get your attention in the crowded place, I simply walk up and stick my nuts in your face. Yeah, freak her with your nuts, yo, that'll get her. Tell her that she's fat, yeah, that'll work even better. Look, fuck you, I got a strong rap. You don't want contestant number two, he's mad whack. I walked into a barn, and there he was, standing up by the bucket, trying to fuck it. It was a big fucking smelly ass farm llama. Yeah, dog! How you gonna diss your mama?